Then he was a bit upset about not being booked.
Did he have words, Howard?
No. Typical Vinny. He turned it into a terrific moment, then lifting the atmosphere. I'm last on the bus, I sit down. In about a minute, I feel something in my head here. And I turn around, and it's Vinny with his 12 ball. So, but again, Vinny, most people didn't know. They knew that Vinny, that he wanted them to sit there sometimes. But he was terrific at it. And I've told him, probably my biggest mistake was selling him. Because he would have been... Vinny was a great team person. Great team person, he was. Yeah, great for Monroe. And a couple of other things about him was that he was a lad who used to come and watch his train in a wheelchair. He was about 7, and unfortunately he was turning ill. And he came to the games as well. And he'd put a wheelchair on the track, people would always run off and say hello to him. But what people didn't know, that every couple of weeks, Vinny would turn up at the house and say to the mum, "You know, go and get yourself 2 hours. Let me have it." Obviously, he don't say, and if you get a chance in the third year, we won't take it. But again, set targets which you think are achievable and which they can recognise as achievable because you give them reasons why they are so. Looking at the last 10 seasons, in any league, look at the last 10 seasons, sit down with an analyst and he'll hit the analyst these days and he'll tell you how many steps you've got to take in the first 5 games if you're a striker, and so on. So, people are much better dealing with it. If you say we can climb Mount Everest, terrific, and we can climb Mount Everest, but then if we're going to do that, we've got to break it down to so where's the first day going to end, and the second day going to end, and what are we going to be doing on that day, and what have we got to get to on that day, and so on. So it's good to look in the long term, but to get to there, it's step by step. So, yeah, it's just easy for us all to cope.
And when the Glorious Day came around, obviously the Sheffield United game was so important. We've been speaking an awful lot about this tonight, throughout the night, ladies and gentlemen. But that Sheffield United day itself was so important. We worked with obviously Man United having to go to Liverpool and what have you. When we did finally get over the line, Howard, because obviously a few weeks before we had that big defeat at City, we lost 4-0. When we did get over the line, obviously you're elated to win the title, we know that. But we were a little bit upset that some of the press were saying, and again, Ian Wallace, I think it's Ian Wallace, or Ian Willis alluded to this as well. You were annoyed a little bit with the press, the way the reaction to Leeds United were, in fact, they lost it rather than us win it. But that ground other arguments, didn't it? That really annoyed us as fans, because we'd done enough. And we won by 6 points in the end. Did that annoy you at all, Howard, or were you not really bothered?
No, when we lost at Man City, I and my assistant, Mike Langer, we sat down on Sunday and had to walk about an hour toward the end of the meeting. And we looked at the fixtures. And I was then able
Cheers.
To sit the players down on Monday and say, these are the four games we've got less. I think if we win three and draw one, that would be a great achievement. The one game I think we need to draw, win if we can, will be Liverpool. Because I've looked at their fixtures, I think 10 points, well, three wins and a draw is achievable for us. And by the way, their last game is at Liverpool, and they will be trying not to lose, as it were. They'll not have them winning the title. So what we have to do is forget about winning the title. We have to try to ensure that last game matters for them. And I said, and so, unless we get injuries, this will be the team for those three, four games.